I quite entered into your refined, allegorical manner, the delightful delicacy with which you gave me to understand, by means of subtle insinuations, that you wished the fact of your engagement to be made known. Yes, ladies, it is all true. This very evening the prince knelt at my daughter's feet, and actually, and by no means in a dream, made a solemn proposal of marriage to her.
Yes, yes, quite so, just exactly like that, and under the very circumstances she describes, just like reality, said the old man.
My dear young lady, he continued, bowing with his greatest courtesy to Zina, who had by no means recovered from her amazement as yet.
My dear young lady, I swear to you, I should never have dared thus to bring your name into prominence, if others had not done so before me. It was a most bewitching dream, a bewitching dream, and I am doubly happy that I have been permitted to describe it. Charming, charming!
Dear me, how very curious it is! He insists on sticking to his idea about a dream, whispered Mrs. Antipova to the now slightly paling Maria Alexandrovna. Alas, that great woman had felt her heart beating more quickly than she liked without this last little reminder.
What does it mean? Whispered the ladies among themselves.
Excuse me, prince, began Maria Alexandrovna, with a miserable attempt at a smile, but I confess you astonish me a great deal. What is this strange idea of yours about a dream? I confess I had thought you were joking up to this moment, but if it be a joke on your part, it is exceedingly out of place. I am anxious to ascribe your conduct to absence of mind, but—
Yes, it may really be a case of absence of mind, put in Natalia Dmitrievna in a whisper.